Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily presentation for Tuesday, May 17th, 2011. I'll be very brief this morning, not a lot of charts. We've got Hewlett-Packard out with earnings, and the stock's down about 5%. Hewlett-Packard is in the Dow 30, so futures are holding up a lot better than you would expect. We do have commodities down in the pre-market this morning, and futures are basically unchanged. So we've got Hewlett-Packard. It's been in the doghouse since the last quarter. Previous quarter before that, it was just trading in the flypaper channel. So the stock has not been held in high regard for some time. Compare Hewlett-Packard to IBM, totally different picture. People have been buying the dips in IBM. It's been very successful. Buying the dips in Hewlett-Packard has been very painful. So two completely different stocks, Hewlett-Packard down in the pre-market. Looking at Tuesday's roadmap, we've got the VIX on a buy signal. Traded above the previous two highs, didn't close there, but it's looking pretty strong. So close below 16.97 on an hourly basis on Tuesday would give us a sell signal. The S&P 500 broke down yesterday below the previous couple of lows. Flypaper channel in the 13.45 area. If we start to move higher, that's where we'd expect to get stuck. On the downside, if we continue to move lower, 13.20.31 is our next target. 13.12.50 is the next target below that. That takes us down to the bottom of the open gap. Looking up to the upside on Tuesday, an hourly close above 13.39.70 would give us a buy signal, and we would turn bullish on the market if that were to happen on Tuesday. Take a look at commodity ETFs. What I'm looking for when I scan through the charts is anything trading in the channel. And so we've got copper up to the lower channel line, but not into the channel. Gold has been trading in the channel for the last week. We're looking for a close above 140.97 for the GLD. SLV, nowhere near the lower channel. Nowhere near the lower channel for coal, for crude oil. For gasoline, big down day yesterday. This is great. We're coming up to a couple of long weekends, one in Canada, one in the United States. Great to see gasoline continue to move lower at this time of the year. And looking at natural gas traded in the channel yesterday, potential buy signal on Tuesday. It's a nice chart pattern here. You'll see we've got a couple of, we've been making higher highs and higher lows over the past couple of months, and a close above 11.28 for the natural gas ETF would give us a buy signal on Tuesday. Take a look at indexes. I'm not going to go through all the indexes today. No changes yesterday for most of them. We've got the VIX still on a buy signal here, a close below 16.09. We had a big up day for the VIX for the NASDAQ 100. We need to close below 14.87 to change that on Tuesday. That big up day came with a big down day for the NASDAQ 100. If we're looking at the NASDAQ 100, we're also looking at the Qs and the corresponding leveraged ETFs for the NASDAQ 100. So big down day yesterday. Down day yesterday for the Russell took out the recent lows. The Zacks Microcap took out the previous two lows. And so we're back at prices we haven't seen since March for the microcap sector. Semiconductors now on a sell signal, as are cloud computing stocks. And Cramer's Mobile Internet Index has been on a sell signal for a while, continued to move lower yesterday. Looking at some of the stocks I watch in the technology sector, Apple Computer has been on a sell signal, sharply down yesterday. Google was on a sell signal and down yesterday, traded below the recent lows. Baidu's been on a sell signal for a couple of weeks now. Sell signal for eBay. eBay had that pop, didn't get it very far. eBay has pawned off Skype and made a few billion dollars on it, and still did not help the stock. We're on a sell signal now. Microsoft. Microsoft's in the Dow 30. Notice it took out the two recent lows. And so we're back at prices we haven't seen for quite a while for Microsoft. That's not a good omen for the rest of the market. Research in Motion continued to move lower yesterday, looking for a move down to 37.50. And looking at Yahoo, another big down day. We're back at prices we haven't seen since January for Yahoo. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning. No change in the status of commodities, no change in the status for all the major indexes, except the NASDAQ, which broke down yesterday, and semiconductors went with it, and so we're looking for weakness in technology stocks with Hewlett-Packard reporting and being down over 5%. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.